ಕೋರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಮೆಂಬರ್ ಕುಂದ್ರಿ
ಪತ್ರಕರ್ತರ ಮಾಧ್ಯಮದ ಮೀಡಿಯಾದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸನ್ಮಿತ್ರರು ಕೂಡ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕವಾದ ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಈ ಪತ್ರಿಕಾ ಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ರಾಜ್ಯದ ಜಾತ್ಯತೀತ ಜನತಾದ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರು ಮಾಜಿ ಮುಖ್ಯಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ನಮ್ಮ ನಾಯಕರಾದ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ಕುಮಾರಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಅವರು ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೋರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿಯ ಮುಖಂಡರುಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಮತ್ತೊಮ್ಮೆ ಹಾರ್ದಿಕ ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತವನ್ನು ಬಯಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಈ ದಿನ ಹುಬ್ಬಳ್ಳಿಯಲ್ಲಿ
ಹುಬ್ಬಳ್ಳಿ ಕೋರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿ ಮೀಟಿಂಗ್ that we give you the details of what happened in our core committee meeting
ಕರೆದಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇದಾದ ನಂತರ ಮೇ 7ನೇ ತಾರೀಕು ನಡೀತಾ ಇರತಕ್ಕಂತ
that will be held on May 7
14 ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳ
in the second round of elections in Karnataka
ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರುಗಳು ವಿಧಾನಸಭೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಭ್ಯರ್ಥಿಗಳಾಗಿದ್ದಂತವರು
we have already appointed observers and also party leaders who will be looking after the second phase of elections on May 7 across Karnataka
ಒಂದು ಸಭೆಯನ್ನು ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಕರೆದಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಸಭೆ ಮುಗಿದ ಕೂಡಲೇ
ಆ ಸಭೆ holding detailed discussions with these leaders who will be looking after what's happening in the second phase of elections and also the main discussion that we had today was about the elections across the 28 constituencies across Karnataka.
28 ಲೋಕ ಸಭೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ 14 ವಿಧಾನಸಭಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳ ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳ ಚುನಾವಣೆ ಮುಗಿದು ಉಳಿದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಕಿತ್ತೂರು ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ, ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ,
now that we are done with the 14 seats, 14 constituencies across Karnataka, the focus now shifts to the other 14 seats that are in play as far as the second phase of elections are concerned. And as we are in coalition with the BJP, we will be ensuring that they emerge victorious, and that is the focus, and that was discussed in the core committee meeting.
ನಾಯಕರುಗಳು ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರು ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಕುಂದುಕೊರತೆಗಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಿವಾರಣೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ಉಳಿದಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಐದಾರು ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ
ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪ್ಲಾನಿಂಗ್ ಆನ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಅಪ್ರೋಚ್ ದಿಸ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬೂತ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ದ ಡಿಸ್ಕಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಆನ್ ವಿತ್ ಆರ್ ಅಲಯನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಜೆಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಟು ಕೀಪ್ ಅ ಫೋಕಸ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್
ಬಹಳ ಯಶಸ್ವಿಯಾಗಿ ಒಗ್ಗಟ್ಟಾಗಿ ಸಣ್ಣ ಪುಟ್ಟ ತೊಡಕುಗಳು ಏನ್ ಬಂದರೂ ಕೂಡ ನಾವು ಅದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ನಿವಾರಣೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಸಹಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲವನ್ನ ಗೆದ್ದು ನರೇಂದ್ರ ಮೋದಿಯವರನ್ನ ಪ್ರಧಾನಿ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತೇಳಿ ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಷ್ಟ್ರೀಯ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರಾಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಎಚ್ ಡಿ ದೇವೇಗೌಡರ ಏಕೈಕ ಗುರಿ ಏನಿದೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ರಾಜ್ಯಾಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರ ಗುರಿ ಏನಿದೆ, ಇದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಇವತ್ತು ಈ ಸಭೆಯನ್ನ ನಾವು ಕರೆದು ಕೋರ್ ಕಮಿಟಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ 14 ಲೋಕಸಭಾ ಕ್ಷೇತ್ರಗಳ ವಿಷಯದ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಚರ್ಚೆಯನ್ನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ.
About all the 14 constituencies that are up for election next, and we've given responsibilities to leaders, and we also appointed leaders that will be ensuring that the elections are fought along with the BJP, and that we ensure that the victory is for the NDA alliance.
Bharatiya Janata Paksha mukhandaral jothenu kuda ivatte nam core committee
will also have a detailed discussion with the BJP later in the day, and we'll of course tell them about all the details that we've discussed in our core committee meeting, and along with the BJP we will prepare a detailed strategy on how to approach the phase 2 of the elections.
The
final aim is to ensure that we win all the seats in Karnataka, and the discussions in the core committee were about these 14 seats, and also to ensure that there are more memberships for the party, and we'll have a detailed discussion on that later on in another meeting after the election.
ಮತ್ತೊಂದು ವಿಚಾರ ಹಾಸನದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ
ಲೋಕಸಭಾ is about Hassan, and the focus here is on Prajwal Revana and the allegations that have come to the fore against him.
ಏನು SIT ತನಿಖೆಯನ್ನ
the government has already formed an SIT in this matter.
ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ.
And we welcome the move of the state government to ensure an SIT probe against our Hassan MP candidate Prajwal Revana, and whatever the result of that probe is, we will look for that. But meanwhile, there is nothing as of now that has come. But we will not give out any statements against it. We will not do anything that defers the probe or affects the probe. We will completely support the probe of the SIT against Prajwal Revana. And we have decided to ensure that we will give all support that is required to ensure a free and transparent probe. The allegations are very serious and they concern women and their dignity, and these are the allegations that are coming to the fore against Prajwal Revana. And as these are very serious allegations, we have decided to suspend Prajwal Revana from the JDS. This decision has been taken by our national president H.D. Devegowda. In fact, we have recommended this decision to him from the core committee. He'll have to take a final call on that. He will have to take a final decision on this, but the core committee has decided that Prajwal Revana should be suspended from the JDF, and this final decision on this will be taken by H.D. Devegowda, who is our national president. Once a final call is taken by H.D. Devegowda, it will reach our state president, who will then announce it officially. Before the press conference ends, we will get a decision from H.D. Devegowda. The government has already ordered an SIT probe, and whatever the details that come out from that, we will ensure that the state government takes an action basis that. And based on the SIT probe, based on the details of the SIT probe, once all those details are out, we will decide on how many years Prajwal Revana will be suspended for. But right now, the decision that the core committee has taken is to recommend the suspension of Prajwal Revana to H.D. Devegowda. JDS absolutely does not stand with such issues, and JDS does not support any actions that affect the dignity of women. No families must be affected, and this is a very, very serious issue that has escalated across the state. And this is an issue that has just come up before the elections. The pen drive has been leaked. And for the first 5 days, nobody discusses. There were no discussions on it when the pen drive was leaked. ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಈ ಒಂದು ಘಟನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ
तो आपको बता दें जेडीएस कोर कमेटी की एक बैठक हुई और फिलहाल रेवन्ना को पार्टी से निकाल दिया गया है और साथ ही साथ आपको बता दें उनके खिलाफ एक्शन भी लिया जाएगा।
इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो देन लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब टू ईटी नाउ।